It's gonna leave with a turn one Graft Digger's Cage here. Which hinders some lines from Storm, but not others. Obviously, if he needs to use Past and Flames to win, then Graft Digger's Cage is very good. So he can find pressure for his Life Toll to make Ad Nauseam look not appealing, then the turn one Graft Digger's Cage gets a lot better. So my Flooded Strand is going to fetch a Tropical. Definitely going to Brainstorm first. Probably just going to pass the turn, although if Brainstorm finds a Stoneforge Mystic, then I'll probably want to just cast, like, if I could Brainstorm into Stoneforge Mystic here, that would be awesome. I think I'm going to jam that. Huh. We could have also held Brainstorm to help protect our hand against his discard, but if he's trying to go off, doesn't do that much for us. Alright, so we definitely need to shuffle before we draw, so I'm going to stop on my upkeep. Kind of telegraphs that we have a Stifle, but oh well. That's why I crack on my upkeep a lot in real life. One of the reasons, anyway. Ooh. Play a Jace. How do I feel about playing Jace here? Pretty good, actually. Yeah, I'm just gonna do that. Jace is sort of pressure. Interesting. Well, Jace is a good one to pitch to Force of Will, so I think I'm going to put back like this. And then if he doesn't kill us on his turn 3, we should be in decent shape to win the game, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. Obviously holding up Stifle for his Misty here is tempting, because it denies him resources. But it's not worth, like, not playing a Jace the Mind Sculptor. Like, that's not the case. Playing Jace just seems correct. The sooner we get Jace into play, the sooner we can find a Dreadnought and actually start doing things. If he's got, like, Cabal Therapy plus the win here, which he should, I mean, it's turn 3, there's a reasonable chance. Hopefully this Graft Digger's Cage is actually like relevant in that regard. But we'll see. I don't think he can let me untap with this hand, because the Shadow of Doubt is actually relevant against his other line. Like, he needs to use Infernal Tutor to find some wins. The Ponder here is a good sign. Means that he doesn't like naturally have the kill. And he's using Black Mana Source to cast the Ponder, which means that he probably has another one in hand, because I think he would like to therapy with me while I'm tapped out. Yeah, we could have gone Stifle into Shadow of Doubt. I mean, he would have played around the Shadow of Doubt. It would have ended up like eating another one of our turns to hold it up to get this fetch land. The nice thing about having a deck full of Stifles and such is that we can actually Fate Seal him out of the game, because he needs to crack all of his fetches as sorcery. Yeah, I think I'm going to Fate Seal him with Jace on my turn, and then bottom any discard spell, any filtering spell, like a brainstorm or preordain, and any tutor, like Infernal Tutor. And I'll probably leave pretty much any other card on top. Like mana. Like I'll leave like LEDs and brainstorms and whatever. He's played enough cantrips that if his hand needed mana, he would have it by now. So right now I think what he's filtering for is a discard spell for the Force of Will and possibly the Shadow of Doubt. Yeah, the nice thing about Grafdigger's Cage is that he's not able to just go like Past in Flames, Flashback Therapy on your other Stifle effect. Like he needs the actual multiple discard spells. And 11 is already starting to push it for Ad Nauseam. So we might have a better shot this game than we did last game. Or maybe we just misplayed in the last game, who knows? I don't think so. I think if we had tapped out for the Jit, we would have just died. But I could be wrong. I could definitely be wrong. I don't remember being wrong before, but I'm humble enough to admit that it is a possibility. I just want to play this. He's going to know it's my draw for the turn. That's fine. I'm going to Fate Seal him. Bottom this. No. Ship the turn. I'd probably even let this fetch resolve as opposed to stifling it. Yeah, I'd definitely let this fetch resolve. He's already got so much mana in play. And now I'm willing to brainstorm again. Another Grafdigger's Cage. That could be good. We could also play Batterskull with double Force of Will. And then if he goes Cabal Therapy you, we force it. So we would have to put back Grafdigger's Cage. And then whatever card we didn't want to pitch to the second Force of Will, probably the Shadow of Doubt. And then just cast the Batterskull here. I kind of don't hate that line. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. This loses to double discard spell when we might have been able to beat double discard spell with the hand that we brainstormed into. So it's kind of a calculated risk. If he just goes like Abrupt Decay on Grafdigger's Cage here, then I feel silly. Because if I was going to hold up... Well, I don't know. I don't know about that. Yeah, leaving a Force of Will on top of the library to cantrip into off of our wonky draw card would have been pretty sweet. Because then he therapies us for Force of Will, gets it out of our hand, thinks, okay, go to kill you. And then I play a cantrip, force your card, force your win, feel pretty good about myself. Getting Batterskull into play is pretty strong, though. Just going to let this brainstorm resolve. That's fine. I think he's digging for discard as opposed to win conditions. Like he should already have some kind of something. He's played enough cantrips. I've definitely seen people like just flood out and brick on cantrips. I mean, you can do that with any deck, but it's not likely. The likely situation is that he has some kind of win piece together, but he needs to find the protection for it. Definitely made a lot of land drops over there. Which is a sign that he could be flooding. Not too many lands left in his deck that he can actually fetch out. There might be like one more sea in there and an island. So on our next turn, we're going to play Redundant Cage for sure. And get that, and do the line I talked about. The players can't shuffle library card in my hand and a Force of Will on top of my library. I like the sounds of that a lot. And he's already seen a Force of Will, so he knows to name it with therapy or whatever. Yeah, I actually don't know what all that would play around. Because if we Force Willed his first discard spell, like we let him see our first hand, and he took Force of Will, and then he played Therapy as his second one, and we played Cantrip, then he names Force of Will, because like what else is scary? I'm still going to get a Redundant Cage into play, though. That just makes sense. Oh, God. Okay, so Sword of Fire and Ice can definitely help us lethal him next turn. So I'm going to put Sword on top. Force of Will on top of that. Play a Redundant Cage. Oh, we should play the Redundant Cage after our attack step. Now, if he was holding up Abrupt Decay, he might just Abrupt Decay the Germ to buy time. Yeah, that was bad. We wanted him to... Yeah, just really bad. No, not like super bad or anything. It's not like this egregious error, but there's no reason... Because this is a situation where the Grafdigger's Cage is relevant information, and there's no reason to give him that before making our attack, except that I just, like, wasn't thinking, and that's exactly what it does. He Abrupt Decays the Germ. This decay was probably going to go for our cage otherwise. You know, just playing a little sloppy, a little fast and loose. So now we have to bounce the Batter Skull or what have you. I like our row of discard. That's kind of nice. Duress. I think I Force of Will this. No, I'm not going to do that. If I let Duress resolve, and then he takes Shadow of Doubt. Yeah, I'm going to Force this. Now if he Cabal Therapies us, we can let it resolve and see what he does. Now if he names Force of Will with this one, we can have Shadow of Doubt into Force of Will. Oh, he took Stifle. That's interesting. Okay, so I'm gonna bounce Batter Skull. We're gonna draw Force of Will naturally for our turn. And then I'm gonna Brainstorm to try and hit another blue card. Because that'll just put us in a really good position. Son of a. Darn it. Alright, what do I want to do here? Awkward time to draw Dreadnought. I knew the Sword of Fire and Ice was on top of our library. Okay, I'm going to put back Sword of Fire and Ice, and then Force of Will. No, that doesn't make any sense. I need to keep both Force of Wills in hand. I'm going to put back Dreadnought and Batterskull. I'm going to cast Simeon Spirit Guide, and then I'll be holding up Shadow of Doubt or Force of Will, which is okay. And then Sword Equip next turn only hits for 6. Whereas if we tap out for Batterskull, Sword plus Equip, that's still only 8 damage. Yeah, that's not lethal. Yeah, I don't think playing Batterskull is inherently better than playing the guide. It gives him a little bit more information, I guess. Yeah, I'm actually going to hold the Batterskull in hand. Yeah, just like that. Shadow of Doubt drawing blue card when there's no other blue card in my hand to pitch to Force of Will isn't exciting. It doesn't actually accomplish anything, which is why I did this way. Because now if he therapies me and takes the Force of Wills, at least I can cast Shadow of Doubt. I'll draw Sword of Fire and Ice. I still would like to draw a blue card, so I'm going to brainstorm again. Even though Fate Sealing Him is not that bad. We find Brainstorm. We definitely should have gone hit you with Sword of Fire and Ice pre-Brainstorm, because then we would see a card deeper. But that's fine, we did this. So we should play this now. And this is a little weak to a second Abrupt Decay, but so it goes. At least we're applying pressure, making him use cards. Like, if he plays a second Abrupt Decay, that's fine. We just play Batterskull and keep whittling down his life total. Probably Fate Sealing with Jace next turn. He's down to 3 minutes on the clock. He's actually used way more of his time than us. Do I want to let him draw Abrupt Decay? No, I think I actually want to bottom this. If we can keep him from winning with Ad Nauseam, we're just in really good shape. So getting the Abrupt Decay, like bottoming Abrupt Decay, letting us hit him for 8 next turn down to 1. Like double Graft Digger's Cage is really good against his plan for Past in Flames. It does give him a potential second answer to set Past in Flames, or to enable set Past in Flames, but we'll see. Carpet of Flowers, that's so much mana. Yeah, that's fine. He's already got plenty of mana, so I'm not gonna force a will that card. Mini Tendrils of Agony for 10 damage. I think that's acceptable. a little weird. Less weird. Yeah. So he must have a second tendrils for matchups that he deems that are like control-ish type matchups. It's kind of strange. It's like not very typical at all. I don't think our storm matchup should be amazing or anything, but I definitely think we were in good shape to win this game. I hope I didn't fate seal him down into that second tendrils. Kind of unfortunate. I don't know. Mind reader traps in the sideboard? Who knows? Who knows what the plan should be? I mean, if we force a will of the carpet of flowers there, he still has enough mana to cast both tendrils, and then we give him two more storm for his storm count. Yeah, kind of a bizarre game. Well, I'm still excited to play the next round, see what happens. Yeah, usually you don't want multiple tendrils in your deck, because you can hit them off of ad nauseum, but if you're playing a matchup where you think your opponent's going to have like a ton of counter magic, then you definitely want multiple tendrils so you can naturally tendrils people this way. And he must have gotten that impression of our deck after the game one, and he saw all the Stifles and Trick Binds. He was like, okay, this guy's got a lot of disruption. We're going to need multiples. Going to have to have something for the natural tendrils draw. I'm not sure that was correct. I mean, it definitely paid out for him. Two natural tendrils was pretty much the only way he won from that position. Awkward to fate seal him with Jace and see Abrupt Decay in that situation. Well, anyway, next round. Next round. Next round hype!